Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. In this ocean of Christianity, South Africa, where I come from, we are asked numerous questions. Like, for example, they would like to know what is the relationship between Islam and the other religions. We say, and rightly so, that Islam is not a new religion. It is actually a continuation of the teachings of Moses, Hazrat Musa alayhi salam, and Jesus, Hazrat Isa alayhi salam, brought to perfection. And in that, we say that Islam is Judaism made universal. We claim a unique relationship among the people of the book, the Jews and the Christians. With them, we claim a unique relationship. That Islam is Judaism made universal, is the teaching of Moses sallallahu alaihi wasallam made universal. The Jew says that God Almighty is absolutely unique. He has no partners, he has no sons. God is not seen at any time. No man can see God and live. And we give our hand of acceptance to the Jew that we believe as you believe. The Jew says no eating of the flesh of swine. We say we won't eat it. He says no eating of blood. We say we won't touch it. He says no. He says circumcision. We say we are circumcised. What more do you want? We would say that Islam is Judaism made universal. And we also claim a unique relationship with the Christians in this, that Islam is also the only non-Christian faith which makes it an article of faith for its followers to believe in Jesus. No Muslim is a Muslim if he does not believe in Jesus. We say that we believe that Jesus was one of the mightiest messengers of God. We believe that he was the Messiah, the Masih, translated Christ. We say we believe that he was born miraculously without any male intervention. A miracle of God. And we believe that he gave life to the dead by God's permission and he healed those born blind and the lepers by God's permission. The only real difference between us and the Jew is, we say, is political. With the Jew is political. The Muslim and the Jew are fighting for a piece of land. We say, my brother, the Arab, he says Palestine belongs to him. The Jew says Palestine belongs to him. Both my brothers and my cousins are fighting for a piece of land. It has something to do with politics. It has got nothing to do with race. It has got nothing to do with religion. I am speaking to my South African audience. This is how I present my case. With the Christian, we are the closest in what I have just mentioned now. His birth, his position, his status, his miracles. The only point of real difference is that we say he is not God Almighty in human form, and he is not God incarnate, and he is not the begotten Son of God. These are the points of real difference. Otherwise, the Quran, the manner, the nobility in which it describes the birth of Jesus in the Holy Quran, Surah, in the Holy Quran, we read in Surah Ali Imran, chapter 3, verse 42, says, وَإِذْ قَالَتِ الْمَلَائِكَةُ يَا مَرْيَمُ. So behold, the angel said, O Mary, إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَاكِ وَطَهَّرَكِ وَاصْطَفَاكِ عَلَى نِسَاءِ الْعَالَمِينَ. That God Almighty has chosen thee and purified thee, chosen thee above the women of all nations. يَا مَرْيَمُ قُنُتِي لِرَبِّكِ وَاسْجُدِي وَارْكَعِي مَعَ الرَّاكِعِينَ. So, O Mary, worship thy Lord devoutly. Prostrate thyself and bow down in prayer with those who bow down. ذَلِكَ مِنْ أَنْبَاءِ الْغَيْبِ نُوحِيهِ إِلَيْكَ. That this is part of the tidings of the things unseen which we reveal unto thee, O Apostle, by inspiration, and so on. In these verses, when it is read to them, to the non-Muslim, especially the Christian, and more especially the Roman Catholic, an amazing thing happens. When we read the Quranic Arabic, the Arabic of the Quran, the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and give its translation, the effect that it produces on the listener, we see their eyes well up with tears. And they can't seem to believe their ears, because they have been programmed from childhood into thinking, into believing that we Muslims are the Antichrist, that we are the enemies of Hazrat Isa alayhi salam. When we tell them that we believe in Jesus, we say that he was the Messiah, we believe in his miraculous birth, we believe in his many miracles. In my country, my people, the people who are ruling us, they are thinking that we are trying to curry favor with them, we are trying to be nice to them, that if we say a few good words about their Jesus, maybe they might say a few good words about our Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is not the case, which would be hypocrisy. We have to show them the Quran, and we make them to see, and we read it to them and explain to them, and they bite the fingers. Metaphorically, they bite the fingers and say, look, we were thinking that this was just the opposite. And if they read this, and I told, show them, demonstrated to them, that this birth of Jesus, as narrated in the Holy Quran, is a nobler and a sublimer version of his birth than anything to be found anywhere. Because when this good news was given to Mary, we read in the Holy Quran, she says, قَالَتْ رَبِّ أَنَّا يَكُنُوا لِي وَلَدٌ وَلَمْ يَمْسَسْنِي بَشَرٌ. She says, oh my Lord, how shall I have a son when no man has touched me? Physically, sexually. In other words, she had no relationship with any man, and how is she going to have a child? And the answers to that, as we find in the Holy Quran, قَالَ كَذَلِكِ اللَّهُ يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاءُ, said, even so, Allah creates what He will. وَإِذَا قَدَى أَمْرًا, whenever He decrees a matter, فَإِنَّمَا يَقُولُ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونَ. Whenever He decrees a matter, if He wants to do anything, He merely wills it and the thing comes into being. We said this is the Muslim concept of the birth of Jesus. For God to create a Jesus without a human father, just like that. If He wants to create a million Jesuses without father and without mother, just like that. If He wants to create universes, millions and billions of them, just like that. وَإِذَا قَدَى أَمْرًا, whenever He decrees a matter, فَإِنَّمَا يَقُولُ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونَ, He merely says to it, be and it is. Now, this we have not shared with our fellow countrymen in South Africa. It seems like a novel thing to them. And the rest of the world also, we have failed miserably in presenting the Quran to the unbeliever. In South Africa, we have started translating this book into Zulu, the language of the majority of the sons of the soil, the African. There are some 7 million Zulus in my part of the country, 7 million, the biggest number of people. They are like what the Quraysh were in Arabia. These people are among the Africans, the Zulus. So we have translated the Quran into Zulu. We have translated the Holy Quran into Afrikaans, which is the language of the ruling race. And this was all done by the help of the Islamic courts and affairs of Doha, Qatar. They helped us, alhamdulillah, and their help has gone to such great extent that we have been able to do all these things. And I urge upon Muslims everywhere that they take up the Quran and read it to our brethren, our fellow countrymen, our visitors, our tourists, our expatriates. Read it to them, make it available to them. Let them see the Quran for themselves. Because they have some mysterious ideas, mystic ideas about us. They don't know what is happening in the masjids. They don't know what we really stand for. They don't know what the Quran really says. And this volume that has been produced in your country here has been most useful, because this one is a unique translation that this man, Yusuf Ali, Abdullah Yusuf Ali, Allama Yusuf Ali, some 50 years ago he did this job. And he has been able to arrange for us such fantastic system that you read the verse of the Quran, and you have the translation side by side, so you can also, the Arab can also improve his English. And a very comprehensive index at the back of the Quran, and this index puts everything on your fingertips. Anything you want to, you know about Jesus, open J, and under Jesus you'll find a dozen different references. You want to know about Moses, under M you find Moses. You want to know about marriage, about divorce, everything on your fingertips. You can refer to it in two ticks. May Allah bari ta'ala, you know, make it possible for you to have access to this book of God and use it for the propagation of Islam. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.